What's up, Ducks fans? We are back, going to Honda Center yet again to close off this little three-game homestand that the Ducks have been on. Tonight we play the Boston Bruins, so it's going to be another tough game. Boston is 39-24-8, and they have one of the best offenses in the league, and they're also one of the best road teams in the league. And on top of all that, we beat them 6-2 in Boston earlier this season, so they're not going to be too happy with us. It's Matt Bolesky's first return to Honda Center since he left us last offseason, and honestly, I'm curious to see if he's going to get booed or not, because, I mean, Bolesky is a pretty popular guy with the Ducks, and, you know, I know there were a lot of fans that were still happy with him after he chose to leave, that were still just, you know, giving him support and stuff, you know, good luck in Boston kind of stuff, but... to be honest, like, from my point of view, I mean, we offered him a contract, and he chose to take, from the reports anyway, slightly more money, like, not much more money, to go to Boston. And so it didn't really seem like we offered him a bad deal. And, you know, the fact that he still left anyway, despite coming up in our system, is pretty sad. So, you know, it'll be interesting to see if he gets booed tonight. The Ducks, we are... 38-22-9, and as I said at the end of my last video, we've lost four of our last five games, and we are suddenly pretty far back again for the division lead. And honestly, I was thinking about it the last couple days, and at this point, I don't even really necessarily care if the Ducks win the division. Obviously, I want the Ducks to win the division, but if we don't win the division, it's okay. I just want to be playing good hockey entering the playoffs, because we were playing such good hockey during that pretty much from Christmas until five games ago, and all of a sudden we've just not looked as sharp, and I just want us to be playing good hockey. We've proven this season, we've won the season series against the Sharks and the Kings, so we've proven that we can beat the Sharks, we've proven that we can beat the Kings. One of those two teams is going to be our first round opponent. I'm almost certain that we're going to make the playoffs, so it's going to either be the Sharks or the Kings, unless we win the division, and in that case it'd probably be Nashville, but who knows, obviously a lot can change. But we've proven that we can beat LA and San Jose, though, is my point, and we just need to play good hockey, focus on making the playoffs while playing good hockey, and have our game together, and then see who we get. And if we don't win the division, we don't win the division. Like, I just want to see good hockey from the Ducks. That's kind of where I'm at right now as the season really, I mean, we get into the home stretch here of the regular season. And a few notes, Freddie Anderson will be in net tonight for us. John Gibson, I hear, is actually feeling a little under the weather, but he's still the backup, I believe. But Freddie will get the start. And also, Kevin Bieksa is available tonight, should Bruce choose to go with him. So we'll see if Bieksa is playing or not. I definitely hope so, because Corbinian and Holzer, I just don't... I mean, he's just not as good. I'm not trying to be mean, but I would... Yeah, we'll see, I guess. Yeah, I'm going to try to redo my pick from a couple games ago. I picked us to beat the Rangers 4-3, so I'm going to pick that again tonight. 4-3, Ducks win against the Bruins. I was pleasantly surprised when we held them to two goals last time, and it'd be nice if we could hold them to two or less tonight. So we'll see. You know, we held New York to two, so if we can play that same type of defense, maybe we will, but I'm going to say they do get to three, but that we score four. So 4-3, Ducks win. I've got my Ryan Kesler jersey on tonight. See if it brings the magic, and yeah, go Ducks, and I will see you all after the game. All right, Ducks fans, what an awesome game from our Anaheim Ducks, a 4-0 victory over the Boston Bruins, and it felt so good. Just an awesome game by Freddie Anderson. He stopped all 38 Boston shots and was very deservedly the number one star of the game, and he improved his record over the last 18 games to 15-1-1, so he has been doing an amazing job lately. Very big thumbs up to Freddie. And then... our offense, we scored goals tonight too. I predicted that we'd score four. I didn't think that we'd hold one of the top offenses in the league to zero. So, but our offense got it done tonight too, scoring four goals. So, very awesome. We saw in the first period two quick goals by the Ducks. Jamie McGinn scored, and it was assisted by Corey Perry and Ryan Getzlaff. And then shortly after that, Ryan Kessler scored, and it was assisted by Andrew Cogliano and Jakob Silfverberg. Then there was no scoring in the second, but in the third, we had a goal from Hampus Lindholm assisted by Ryan Getzlaff. And then a little bit later in the period, we had a goal from Ricard Raquel, assisted by David Perron and Hampus Lindholm. So, all around, just good night from the Anaheim Ducks. We did see Bruce put Ryan Getzlaff and Corey Perry back on the same line, which, if we keep scoring four goals a game, I definitely don't mind, but I would like to see... I really like having the, like, top, you know, like, the two number one lines, so to speak, where we have, you know, like, I just feel like Getzy and Perron play really well together, and I feel like Perry and Raquel play really well together. And although tonight things worked out, I still prefer it the other way, but it's just an interesting note that Getzy and Perry were on the same line for the whole game tonight. We have not seen that for a very long time. An awesome game. Freddie, 38 shots from the Bruins. I mean, Freddie played an awesome game. I already said that, but just had to mention it again because it was very impressive. And the Anaheim Ducks got the win. It was a pretty huge win going now on a big road trip. Some notes about the game. Clayton Stoner had a fight with Zeno Chara in the third period, and it was pretty hilarious. Like, Stoner embarrassed Chara. And it was pretty awesome. He took him down really quick, and it was pretty huge too, because Stoner can take out a guy like that for the other team for 5 minutes. It's definitely a win for us, and that's what happened. That was pretty fun. And then also, I'm just gonna preface this by saying, like, I'm not a big fan of Boston sports. I should word it more negatively than that. I hate Boston sports, and whether it's the Red Sox or the Bruins, or especially the Patriots and the Celtics, I do not like Boston sports. And there was actually a Bruins suck chant that started. And it's like, the Ducks fans, like, we're typically pretty classy. Like, we don't do a whole lot of nasty chants, but the Bruins suck chant started, and I couldn't help but love it. Because, I mean, it was, you don't hear anybody sucks chants really at Honda Center, hardly. And for it to be the Bruins, to be the team that we chose to chant against, I was like, this is pretty funny right now. Sorry, Bruins fans, if any of you happen to be watching by some slim chance. Sorry, not sorry. The Ducks, we've been dominating the Bruins lately. We've now won 5 straight against them and 8 of the last 10. So that's been nice. So also this season we outscored them 10-2, so that's pretty crazy. And while we're talking about scoring, this homestand, which, I mean, was not an easy homestand, New Jersey and New York and Boston, we outscored our opponents 12-3, so we averaged a 4-1 victory. It's just a shame because two of those games were a 7-1 victory and a 4-0 victory, but then we had the 2-1 loss to the Rangers. So sandwiched in between these pretty high scoring games for us was that not so great game against the Rangers, but it was still good to see overall on the homestand. Got 4 out of 6 points. If, you know, coming into the homestand, if I had known we would have gotten 4 out of 6, I would have been like, all right, that's not bad. Because, I mean, this was not an easy homestand. So, well done to the Ducks for that. And let's see if there's anything else I wanted to talk about. I think that's about it. I mean, we got on the road now for 5 games. It's a huge swing across Canada. It starts in a couple days on Sunday against Winnipeg, and then after that we play Montreal, Toronto, Ottawa, and then we close it off against Edmonton. So that's our next 5 games. And a little correction I wanted to make too from the beginning half of the video. I said I predicted a couple of games ago that the Ducks would beat the Rangers 4-3. Obviously, I meant last game because it was last game that we played the Rangers. So, I meant a couple days ago. So just a little correction. But yeah, so awesome win by the Ducks. And hopefully we can go out now on the road. I would say I hope the Ducks get, 7 or 8 points on this road trip. That might be asking a lot, but that would be a pretty successful road trip. Hopefully we can go out and do that. If we want to maintain a chance to win the division, we have to do that. But like I was talking about in the first half of this video, if we don't win the division, it's not the end of the world. We'll see what happens. But I still think, it'd be cool to go out and get 7 or 8 points. So we'll see. I won't be making a video for almost 2 weeks, but go Ducks, and I will see you all later. Jamie! Sorry. Okay, we'll start over. Okay.